Hi, my name is Roger. This is the first video that I'm going to do about calculators. And it's going to be a small series. You will end up with something similar like you see on your screen. Now, this one is called Panther 7 Dark Legion. You can download this one or another calculator with a different interface of my Panther 7 playlist. But you will have at the end of the series something similar like this one. Now, this one has this as an animation, and the only difference is that yours will not be animated the way this one is. But if you download the same images, and you can, because in the description of this video is a download link to my drive, you can download this complete interface, the images for it, and you will end up with this one. Now, this one looks, well, it's not animated the way the other one is, but as you can see, it looks a little bit like an animated calculator. So, download the images or this version or another version and follow this video series about that calculator. Here on the left side, we have a few properties. Here you see the file that you can download, Dark Style. That's this interface with the push buttons, of course. But the interface will be dealt with at the last moment. We start with the code first. Here we have the variables called result is a boolean, percentage clicked, this is Dutch for percentage. Percentage clicked is a boolean, operator sign is a string, operator pressed is a boolean, num1, 2 and 3 are declared as currency, as you can see up here. That gives you larger numbers. And we have I as an integer. Then we start with two labels. We have two labels on the interface. Let me show you. Let me get the background image for a moment off, like this. Here you can see the first one and the second one. This one is called LB History. This one is called LB Screen. That's it. So let me get that interface back. That looks a little bit nicer here. Need my panel. There we have it. So those are two labels. The first label, the history label, is for the history, of course. You can do this in the inspector, but I do it in code, so you add an open event to your label and you're going to enter, if you do it this way, of course, me.textAlign is me.AlignLeft. That results, the first line results in this here. Normally it's here, now it's over here. The text color of that label is blue, some kind of blue, as you can see here. Then the text size is 20. It starts off with 20. Then we go to the screen. I have to do it like that, otherwise this one disappears. The screen has also an open event. Text align is text center, results in this. The color is almost, well, most red. And the text size is 26. So this one is just a little bit bigger than the history. Then we go to our one of our many canvases, because this here is the code behind it, behind the mouse down, of course. You know what this is, you have to use that. If you don't know what it does, read the manual or go to the video custom button or a custom slider or a custom radio button. I believe I explained that in those videos, so we're going to skip that. We have here, when you press on the one, so this one, then this will be executed. If screen.text is or has a nil on it, so it looks like this, or result is true, someone pressed the result button, then this part of the code will be executed. We clear the screen label, we clear the history label as well, and we're going to say screen.text is screen.text, and we're going to add a 1. And with the history, you do exactly the same thing. Result is false. Else, we're going to do this. Screen.text is screen.text. So whatever is on that label. And we're going to add a one. With the history, we do exactly the same thing. Now, from nil to nine, all you have to change is this here, the number that you're going to add. First of all, normally you would see something like this. Let me show you real quickly. LBScreen.text is equal to LBScreen.text. And then people write this here, me.caption. Me.caption, you can use that if you use push buttons, but we don't use push buttons, so we can't use this because there's nothing there. So you have to do it this way. So in case you want push buttons, you can do it with that line that I just deleted. So what does this do? Well, now it has a nil on it, the screen label, so this will be met and it will clear out the screen label. The history label as well, and it will simply put one on that label. There you have it. Now, if there is not a nil on the label, like here, then it will do this here. So if you press now number one, you probably want 11 on your screen, and it does. If you don't have that, let me show you real quickly. If you don't do the clearing, it will result in this. Here we have now nil. So when I press this one, it should delete the nil here and here. But it doesn't. Now this is not what we want. This is what we want. This. So that's it for this video. In the next video, we will continue with the calculator.